guys, how are you? I hope that everybody's doing very well, Scorps. This is going to be for you. This is going to be an energy pull. So if this resonates, go ahead and thumbs up the video here on the YT. If it doesn't resonate, you guys, I'll have your playlist linked below in the description box. But yeah, Scorpio, all the information is in the description, especially when it comes to personals. The packages are not updated, but, and I really don't have, every day I'm like, I'm going to update it. It's in the middle of the month of September. You guys still don't have your package, girl. It's been busy. Okay. Your girl have been busy. But yeah, let's see what we have for you, you guys. I'm trying to shuffle, but I'm having a hard time. Holy Spirit, Holy Father. Holy angels, what's going on for Scorpio? Energy, what is the energy for Scorpio? What is the message for Scorpio? This is a general reading, so it's not going to resonate for every Scorpios out there, but if it does, remember to thumbs up your video, Scorps. It really helps the channel, and it really does help the video to grow and to reach a wider audience as well. All right, so I'm seeing something flipped here. I feel like a lot of you are definitely, I don't know, I'm not going to say waiting, but a lot of you are going through some kind of transition with this Knight of Cups energy. This could be a Scorpio, Pisces, or Cancer energy. And I feel like this person needs to apologize. Tell me more. Yeah, there's a huge regret there. I feel like this person is going to come to you and apologize. Sooner than later, because I'm seeing them having this huge regret about you, something about walking away from you. This is what I'm seeing, but they're very prideful, this energy. And I'm also seeing that they're praying and hoping. Look at how they're putting their hands on their head, you know, tapping into their third chakra, just trying to get some kind of wisdom and trying to get some kind of new direction, hoping that their prayers are going to be answered here. I feel like this person has a lot of like regrets when it comes to you or whatever situation they got themselves in here. I'm also seeing the Six of Cups energy, the Two of Wands. We have the Seven of Swords. So there's a lot of lies that happened here, Scorpio. And with the Six of Cups energy, I felt like this was a contract between you and this person. Like you're supposed to be in each other's lives. But I feel like something changed within you. This is also unfinished business here with this Six of Cups past energy. This could be a karmic relationship as well. But I feel like this person has a lot of memories about you. This person is thinking about you. They don't know why. You might be tapping into their energy as well. And you don't know why, because things change for you clearly within this energy. But I feel like there's a choice that needs to be made here, that needs to be made. And why am I seeing choice? Like, not only choices, but things are coming to light, okay? So a lot of you might be playing detective and trying to find out whatever truth or clarity on your own. Okay? Whatever depression that you were in, you're definitely tapped out of it. But I don't feel like this is a relationship that you want to walk away from, Scorpio. I'm seeing like you both still want to be here. I'm seeing a lot of fight within this connection. Like, even though things are going south, it's like this fight is still there. I'm also seeing like it's time to like close chapters. It's time to heal. It's time to let go of the past. This could also be mistakes that this person have made, you know? And you kind of hold on to it, especially if somebody has been bringing you through a lot of trials and tribulations within a Nine of Wands energy, okay? Where you're going through so many transitions with this person, you're giving them chances after chances, and you're holding on to those experiences here, okay? So the angels are saying it's time for you to heal, time for you to close these chapters. And I feel like you're going to be letting go from this energy because it's holding you down. And you're realizing at this point that it's not helping the situation. It's making the situation worse. So a lot of you were dealing with depression, stress, and anxiety. Have this fear that this person was going to betray you again. And now you're realizing that you can't control others, you know. And, you know, I'm a Scorpio too. So that's something that we have to all learn, right? And for those of you who are Scorpio sun and then you have a Scorpio moon, welcome, y'all. I've seen a lot of, I don't know what it is, but a lot of Scorpio have Leo moon as their moon sign. Like I just said that, but I just don't, and it's kind of crazy because we're already stubborn within the sun. And then we're stubborn within that Leo energy as well. And this is why we're so much of power. We like power. We like our independence. And when that's like threatened or taken away from us, it's like this, Scorpio. You don't mind giving away your what do you call that? Your masculine to someone, because you don't want to be in charge all the time. You want to be able to let go and relax, right? But when you let go your masculine, your power, it feels like, and someone is not doing good by you and someone is playing you, that really unbalances you and make you feel a certain kind of way. So, you know, it's just so crazy because a lot of us are being judged, you know, a lot of Scorpios be judged, you know, wrongly. You know, we're very, you know, stubborn. We're all about power, you know, we're all about control. And if we meet someone that is, you know, trustworthy, and we can definitely trust them and know that they would never hurt us and leave us, Scorpios don't have any problem letting their masculine go. They would love to just lay on the beach and just relax and know that the bills are going to get paid. I'm not going to be cheated on. My person is always going to be with me. The love that I have is true, you know? But we're just so mistrust. And for those of us who have Leo, and there was one comment that I saw that says, I'm a Scorpio sun, I'm a Leo moon, and a Leo rising. Bless you. Bless you. Because you are stubborn. You are stubborn, and plus, you know, Leos love like luxurious items and money. And if they don't have that, they fall into some kind of depression. So you have two energies within your chart. Well, within your birth chart, that's like the major, you know, personality traits of yourself. And then you have Scorpio as your sun. Oh, bless you. Bless you, bless you, bless you. But anyways, you guys. Oh my God, I'm seeing this person working on something, you know. Whoever this is, you guys, they want to work things out. They want a future with you too. I'm getting love at first sight. Whoever this person is, love at first sight. They're having huge regrets with you. You probably know this person since childhood too, you know. And I'm seeing like maybe you guys, you know, definitely went your separate ways for a second and then you met up again. But, you know, there's some kind of strong connection here. Tell me more. I feel like this person is trying to impress you. Yeah, two of cups, soulmate connection for those of you. Even twin flame is being confirmed here. That I'm having the three of wands. So obviously this person is making their way back to you. There's some kind of separation here. They left you, made you felt very imbalanced, made you felt used within this energy as well. And also this person could have left you for someone else, okay? Left to make you feel very cold. You're standing outside in the cold by yourself, maybe with your child, with your responsibilities. This person is nowhere to be found. Here you are. And dealing with a lot of money issues too. A lot of you didn't have a penny to your name, okay? But I feel like you're going to be working this out on your own, even now within this energy, okay? I don't feel like this person is very independent when it comes to financial gain. I feel like you're going to have to work on that yourself. This is not something that I feel like this person can give you, although their parent have another job or just got a job. Okay, they're trying to impress you here, but there was mutual feelings. There's a lot of feelings here, actually. All right, so I'm getting the King of Pentacles here. I'm getting the Page of Pentacles, King of Pentacles. So obviously, Scorpio, I mean, you're going to be okay, but there is a difference between you and this person. Someone is very immature. Someone doesn't want to be anything at the moment when it comes to stability. This person just want to have fun, live life, and experience, okay? You're at a page where you just want stability. You want a family, you want a house, you want money in the bank, you want a good job, you want food in the refrigerator. You just want stability. You want your house, your foundation to be very firm. No one could come in and try to destroy it. This person is all about, let's have fun. Let's just live in the moment. You're not about that life. Not right now. So you both are like, at the moment, vibrating two different frequencies at this moment, okay? This is what I'm seeing here. Tell me more. Wow, Wheel of Fortune in reverse. Even though it's in reverse, it's still a faded connection, but it's just something that happened. It's a cycle. It's a cycle between you and this person. That's what I'm getting here. But I feel like you're not giving me the vibe. Even though the Six of Cups is in reverse, like you want to leave, you know? You're giving me the vibe that this is complicated and you still love this person and you're still fighting for your person. But I'm seeing like you're going to be the one that's going to be holding this together, because look, clearly you have the victory. Things are going to be good for you. You're going to figure your way out of this. I feel like a lot of you, your chart is about independence. Like this life, even though you're supposed to still be with someone, it doesn't mean when your chart is like basically independence, especially in your seventh house. I'm not gonna get into that, you guys, but your life purpose, like you're supposed to be here to experience independence, doesn't mean that you're not supposed to be with someone. Okay, so just remember that. Because I feel like you're definitely here for independence, because you're going to be great. You're going to be successful. You're going to have the victory. Scorpios, okay? But I feel like you're going to have to do this on your own, okay? When it comes to this connection, though, there's a dim opportunity for you and this person to work it out. Tell me more. The Tower is also showing up here. So this is happening very quickly, or this happened very quickly. Remember I told you about power? I told you about Aries? Well, fire signs, Leo. Okay, Leo, Aries, Sag, fire sign. And then you have Scorpio here, okay? And when you put fire signs together, well, Scorpio, you could be a fire sign yourself. Even though you're water-based, you're still considered fire. You could be both because you share the Tower within Aries. So this is why I'm like, oh my God, your sun sign is basically fire, but you're ruled by water. And then you have Moon, Leo, then you have, for that comment that I saw, you have rising, your rising sign, oh my God, your shell sign is Leo as well, so oh my God, the power, did you just see that? Oh my God, the power of it all. And this is what it creates, a Tower moment, like you're not with the games, period. Anybody piss you off, you ready to see them out the door. Okay, Leo, 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 Scorpio, Leo energy. You're ready to dump somebody real quick, especially when they piss you off or when they cheat on you. It's like, wait a minute, you cheated? I'm not a cheater though, but you cheating? Okay. All right, that don't sound too good. All right, so we have the Page of Swords. So you're seeing some kind of jealousy as well. This person is so jealous and envious about you. They're giving you some kind of embarrassment. Or the Five of Swords energy, which is like, you know, trying to like make you look stupid in front of people, talk down to you, be loud. Like if you're trying to tell your story and this person is around, they take away your shine, or try to take away your control of everything. They're trying to take the room from you. I feel like for some of you, when this person is not around, you're happy because you can actually be yourself. But I feel like there's going to be communication, because I'm also getting the King of Swords energy. You're putting your feet down. You're putting your feet down. The High Priestess is here as well in the future energy for you. I just feel like you're going to be an energy where you're very secretive, quiet. You already made up your mind here. Again, a very strong, firm energy that this person is not going to see coming. You know, right now you're in love. Right now you're in love, or whatever this is, and you're really giving this person a benefit of a doubt. You're really trying to have them like work things out and to get to where they need to be. give them time. You're being very patient, especially to go through this cycle with this Nine of Wands energy and this Ten of Swords on your back. You know what I mean? I feel like even with this, it's the relationship, is this reminding me as this burden that you're carrying, but at the same time, I'm not seeing you trying to leave. But this is going to create some kind of, because this person, they're low vibration than you, but they're showing up as a contract. So, and the funny thing is they're low, meaning that their life is low. You know, not their spirit, not their soul. Their life is low. The things within this physical world, because they're in this vibration, they're in this body. So whatever they are trying to accomplish while in being this body is very low. So their beliefs are very low. They might just put this on you and make you feel really down and make you feel like you're doing everything wrong. Like whatever you're doing is just never enough. They're trying to make your vibration as low as them. And I feel like this is what's causing this tower moment, because this person is trying to control you. This person is trying to have you kneel, okay? And it's crazy that I just said that word, because you're not going to kneel. Scorpios don't kneel. Kneel to who? To what? Okay. Only to God. But you don't kneel to others. So no, that's not going to happen. All right. So you're very prideful. You know, you're very stubborn as well, Scorps. Very prideful energy as well. So you're not going to kneel. At all. Not where others can see. Maybe in the dark, but you ain't gonna let people see you kneel. Alright? Okay. It says here, careful how you share with the enemy. Oh wait, careful how you share with the enemy. Okay. So there's a lot of envy and jealousy around you. And that's what I picked up with this five and this page of swords energy. Someone is jealous of you. Someone is envious. Someone is trying to deceive you, trying to steal from you as well with this five of swords. And it's crazy how the five of swords is in the upright, because it's still happening, you know. I'm hearing that you might need to forgive and let go of this, because a lot of you did find out about this. But you need to let go of this. You need to heal. You want to be free now. I'm stuck with the baggage you left. I got this card twice today, by the way, with Gemini's reading too. But you're having it too. So, and that's crazy, because it's confirming the Five of Pentacles. Basically stuck, dealing with the bills, dealing with the baggage that this person left you. You're left outside, standing in the cold. This person might have left you for someone else, something else. They just don't want to be in a committed relationship right now, where when it comes to money, when it comes to stability, they can't provide that to you. But it's something about this energy that I'm seeing, like they're having some kind of opportunity within the future, okay? And I feel like within this future energy, because the future energy for me is this 11-11, right? And this new beginning. And then they're having this Eight of Pentacles. So they're building up themselves, okay? But you're going to need be patient. And I saw a lot of comments that you're like, hell no, I ain't gonna wait for this person. Y'all be tripping. Which I understand. I can't even blame you, because I would never tell you to wait for somebody. I would never tell you to wait for someone that is the Knight of Pentacles. This person is not even showing up as the Knight. They're showing up as the Page. So that is even lower rank. And it's in reverse, you guys. So they're not even tapping into that force of energy. Like I said earlier, what this person is all about is about having fun. You know, getting people. They're like basically, you know, that scrub song. How do you sing it again? I don't want no scrub. Something. I don't want no scrub. Sitting on the what? The passenger side of his best friend's ride. Trying to holler at me. Don't come for me. But that's the exactly what you're dealing with. A lot of you are realizing that you're dealing with a scrub. You're dealing with a scrub, y'all. Okay, tell me more, Holy Spirit. Wow, it says, conflicts is over, taking me yet you're all I see. So the conflicts is over and it's taken me. They're saying taking me yet you're all I see. So the conflicts is over. I can't, these cards, listen, okay? I'm gonna fix them. I didn't write them, but I'm gonna fix them. I feel like this is like so many things have happened within you and this person's life that, and again, conflicts after conflicts after conflicts, the Nine of Wands, you know, then you're going through, what is it? The Wheel of Fortune. This is a cycle. This is confirmation. Okay. You're going through so many things with this person over and over again. And there was a decision that this person got pissed, had some pride, couldn't control you, got mad and walked away and thought that you were going to chase them or run after them or something like that. Okay. And now they're regretting doing that. And now I'm seeing like this person is praying for you to return. Okay. But with the conflicts, they're still saying there are still conflicts between you and this person. But at the same time, it's like the thought of you, it's like taking over them. Right. And all they can think about, yet you're all I see. Yet you're all I see. So it's like they're seeing you regardless of everything that they're going through. They're realizing that they adore you. Like, you get on their nerves, but yet you're all I see. I don't want to be with nobody else. I don't want to see nobody else. I'm not ready for anybody else but you. Okay? That's what this person is saying. I'm hearing that you need to forgive, you know? Or forget. Somebody's holding on to what happened. I can be faithful, but good and bad. Somebody is really crazy with that. You love me and I want you, but I come with drama. Okay, tell me more. Secrets growth, plans backfire. You know what I'm getting? Oh my God. This person really thought this was the right thing to do. They said secrets growth, right? Plan backfired. So this person left, and I feel like a lot of you, they left for somebody else. Oh my God, it backfired, or they left you for a new opportunity, because I'm seeing a choice that they had to make, all right? And they still have to make that choice, but they made a choice and they thought it was going to be the best thing for them, and it backfired. I talked about you. Let me tell you, I'm sorry. See, oh my gosh. I talked about you. Let me tell you, I'm sorry. This person is a child, y'all. I'm getting child's play here. Child's play. You're dealing with a child's play person. You know, this person is very cocky too. They think they're all that on a bag of chips, okay? They're saying, let me come over. And what is it? Let me come over. Okay. Well, no, I'm sorry. I'm reading this wrong. Come over. Let me whisper in your ears. Okay. They want you to let them come over and whisper in their ears. Or whisper in your ears. Listen. Okay. Child. Listen. Okay. Oh, my God. You're stupid for not trying and weighing your options. They're calling you stupid. Oh, my gosh. Oh my God, they're trying to put this all on you. Why am I feel like this person tried to return before and you kind of like, look, I need information, because you're doing your own investigation and you can't do it with them being in your face. So I'm just getting that this person is bitter It's like they don't want you to do this investigation. They don't want you to find out the truth, but the truth is already in reverse. It's coming towards you. So Scorpios, be prepared for this. Be prepared for what you're looking for. Okay, you're stupid for not trying and weighing your options. So they're saying there's so many things that y'all could have did to like try to fix this tower, try to work this thing out. But they're calling you stupid, so that's how they talk. Okay. They have the nerve. This person is coming off toxic to me. Toxic to me. Okay? Like, they're saying you stupid. Who does that? Who say, you know, because you're trying to better yourself or you're trying to find out the truth? Okay. All right, let me shuffle y'all. But we're going to tap into some energy. I feel like I need to tap into this person's energy as well. But just give me some time because I'm being pulled, okay? I'm being pulled to this deck. Holy Spirit, what is the message? Holy Father, Scorpio. What is the message here for Scorpio? What is the message here for Scorpio? All right, what's the message here for Scorpio? Secret getaway. What? I'm just reminding myself about that secret card, and now I'm seeing secret getaway. All right, financial ties, you guys. Money issues. I feel like this person has left you in some kind of responsibility. Like I said before, with the Five of Pentacles, because that's considered to be a constant vibration with that card being in the upright. So you're still dealing with some money issues, so pay attention, all right? I'm also seeing revenge here because this person did something to you and you're going to receive some kind of message, text message. Okay, I feel like this is from this person because you're looking like you're really happy to hear what this is, all right? Because you're smiling in this card. So this text message is going to be from this person, but a lot of you are in this revenge mode, trying to get this person back. Wow, is this for real? Okay, it says caught in the act. So a lot of you caught this person. You're doing your investigation and you caught this person in the act. So this is about something that I feel like it doesn't have to be cheating, you guys, but I just feel like whatever you were telling them that you feel like they were doing, you're going to find out is what it is. It is what it is. Exactly that. Tell me more, Holy Spirit. You have a decision to make. You guys are growing apart. This is not what you thought was going to happen. This is not what you wanted. Now you have to make a decision for yourself. This person broke the trust, broke the bond between you and them. Like I said, I feel like you have been through a lot already with this energy. This is what I'm feeling, you guys. You've been through a lot. And I feel like a lot of you were holding on to this connection because, you know, I'm just seeing like you've been together for a long time and it's kind of hard to start over from scratch. A lot of you been with this person, you have the Nine of Wands energy. So you've probably been with this person for a very long time, 15 years, 20 years, relationship, 27 years, but it, or even 7 years of this relationship. And it's just the Nine of Wands is a lot of history between you and this person, a lot of ups and downs, a lot of trials and tribulations. But at the same time, you're protecting each other. With the Nine of Wands, it's a protection, like you're protecting the foundation or trying to protect the foundation, but at the same time, you're beaten up. Because what are you trying to, the thing that you're trying to protect is beating you up. Do you understand? Is giving you all those wounds. It's not someone else that's doing it. It's the person that you're trying to protect here. So, and that's crazy to even think about. But let's just get into this person's energy and see what we have here. Thank you, Holy Spirit. What is this person's energy? What does this person want Scorpio to know? What does this person want Scorpio to know? Holy Spirit. Thank you. I feel like I need more water. I do. What does this person want Scorpio to know? Thank you, Holy Spirit. This person wants Scorpio to know. Ooh. So they lost a lot of money. I told you this person didn't have any. Something to do with they lost their independence. I feel like they were someone that was starting over. This person could have been married before, but they lost their foundation here because they were juggling with someone else. They could have probably juggled with you and they lost everything. Maybe they had someone else before you and they had to make the decision and they lost everything. And now this is who you're dealing with, you know? I definitely see the strength card here as well, where there's a conflict between you and this person and this needs to be addressed. You know, the Angel of Strength is like, look, don't walk away from this. To this person is like they're being pushed back to you in some form of way, okay? Because there's something that needs to be cleared up here. And the crazy thing about this, I felt like you and this person might have been together when you were younger. I don't know. I'm just getting something like this because this is a collective. So take what resonates and throw out the rest. But I'm just getting that someone here that was with this person when they were younger and then they kind of split and went their separate ways and came back together. But I'm also seeing the Three of Cups in reverse here. I'm the Star. And then we have the Magician. Some kind of shadiness is around this. It could be family and friends as well. And it could be their family or their friends or your friends. But don't worry about this because you have the Star. The universe is on your side. I feel like the universe is going to create some kind of opportunity that is going to bring you guys back together, because the thing about the universe is that you're here to nurture each other, you know, within that environment. You're here to help each other to grow within this world, within this experience that you're in right now. I do see some negativity though within the Magician. Like I said, this person called you stupid, you know? Oh my gosh. So that kind of language is definitely Magician in reverse, okay? Someone that is very negative, someone that is very hurtful. They said a lot of hurtful words to you, especially when you guys are arguing and not seeing eye to eye. They just make you feel like the lowest person on earth, you know, the way they come off. And I feel like, again, I was telling you earlier that this person is trying to lower your vibration because you're coming off as an older soul, okay? Someone that is more wiser, more experienced. And this person is not that, period, okay? They're coming off as a Nine of Pentacles in reverse, okay? So you need to be very careful with your energy around this person and how long you guys are with this person. Your angels are also around this. You have the universe on your side plus the angels. Ooh, so you have the Two of Wands energy that's coming up for them as well. And we have the Two of Swords, okay? So this person's saying that they need to make a decision because they made the wrong move, okay? Remember, we got that regret. They made the wrong choice. They had a choice to make, right? And I told you they have a choice anyways, but they have a choice. They're saying that they made their choice and it was the wrong choice. And now they have to, it's like now they have to do something about it, okay? They're in a situation where it's just not working out either. It's not greener on the other side. And now they have to make another decision. This person, who is this? Oh my God. And then we have the angel. It's like this in Sag energy, for those of you who are with a Sag fire sign here. But divine timing, that's all the angels are saying. Like, look, we're working on them, okay? Talk about nurturing yourself and choosing yourself at this moment. Healing is a must. For those of you who are not done it yet, take this time to let your vibration be high as possible, okay? Because this person is going to return and try to lower your vibration even more if they don't take that opportunity to heal, okay? This person clearly needs to heal. That's what I'm getting. This person needs to heal too. Okay, I'm getting toxic. I've been getting toxic with a lot of the relationships today that I'm pulling from. Okay, so toxic behaviors. Okay. Yeah, the Sun is in reverse, Leo energy. You're just not happy. They're not happy. They're sucked your sun dry. And they're not showing up happy within this situation. They're waiting for some kind of information. I feel like when it comes to a job, they just got some kind of offer or some kind of information. And look at how they're sitting on it, you know, very slow. Don't know if this is what they want to do kind of vibe. And you're waiting for the stability of this relationship. And this is, they're like, oh my God. And you know, the example that I'm going to tell you is that this person could have, you know, an opportunity with a corporate job that, you know, is going to pay them very well. And they're like, look, I want to be a painter. And nothing wrong with painters, because I paint and I wish I could make money off of my painting because I love art. Okay. I do things like this, you know. I went to art school, you guys. I don't know if I kept saying that, but whatever. But, so I used to be really good, but now I'm just like, it's been a while. But, you know, and this person is like, I don't want this, you know, and someone is saying, well, do it and, you know, save money so you can go to art and art school and finish, you know, do whatever you want. And they're like, no, I just want to go after my dreams. And they're not very smart. That's what this is, you know, and they're holding off on giving you any kind of offers either when it comes to their hearts. And it's like they care about you a lot. Don't get me wrong, because I do see a lot of love here with this King of Cups, but they're holding on to it and they're like putting up walls. Something about trusting people. They don't trust not just you, but anybody. Okay, and this is where I'm getting like this person has a lot of healing to do. I feel like they've been through a lot of trials and tribulations within in their childhood. A lot of you, they're showing up as someone that has a family with. They're saying they have some kind of stability together. And this is still up in the air as well. So this could be a child. And I'm also seeing the King of Swords. So there's no communication about that. You don't want this person around you at the moment. Even your child for some of you. My gosh, there's a huge loss here. So there's no change within this person's energy, okay? Who they are when you left them is basically who they are now. You're shown up as the King of Pentacles. They're making a decision, some kind of decision that is set here. Finally, they made a decision, and they're going to make a decision with healing. So yeah, I've been talking about that, and this person definitely needs to heal. They're going through a lot of mental and physical agony, and they need to let that go. And they're making a decision because they want to be as successful as you or in that better headspace. They're looking at you as very mentally secured, all right? They're looking at you as being very abundant that way, all right? Like they depended on you for inspiration. They depended on you for happiness, and now that you're not into their life, their sun is in reverse as well, and you have a lot of similarities between each other. This is just the contract that is coming up. This is what I'm seeing here. So Scorpios, you could be dating another Scorpio just like yourself or someone similar to you. So this person could be a Leo moon, or this person could be a Leo if you are a Leo moon, okay? So some of you could be dating a fire sign, like something that has your quality, even though you're water-based, you are water-based by sun, but you have that opportunity to just like tap into fire if you want to, and go back into water. Like, I promise you, when people meet you, they don't think you are water-based. They think you are fire because you're fun, you're passionate, you're very determined, you're hardworking. And not that water signs are not hardworking people, but they're very sensitive people. And the secret about you separating yourself from Cancer's and Pisces energy is that people don't know how to read you, Scorpio. They cannot look at you and say, oh, you're a Scorpio, you're so emotional. No, because Scorpios don't show their face unless you really know them, even if you know them, they don't even tell you. Like, they have to really care about you, and they have to trust you to let that wall down for you to see that they're, you know, water-based, passionate, you know, very sensitive, really, because you go out on your day and you just show a hard mask every day. Like, you do not let people know that you're very sensitive unless, you know, that's your person. So, this energy, I'm just getting like you guys are similar in so many ways, right? But that could also be the contract, and I'm just getting like you want something, this person doesn't want something as well. Like you're ready for something and this person is not ready because they don't have any trust. Like something is holding this connection back. Tell me more, Holy Spirit. I'm seeing an apology. I'm seeing immaturity. Oh my gosh. I'm seeing a second chance. Yeah, I'm seeing this person coming in, but they're very, I'm just getting like they're not as determined as you. And you have to always watch them because they're sneaky. I'm seeing sneaky with this lizard energy. Like they do things that, that surprises you. Like you're like, "Hold on, what?" Then you'll protect your energy here with them because they're showing up. Again, another similar energy. It's like you guys have a lot that you could, like, I feel like, what am I getting? Like, this person has a lot in common with you, but you are on that level. You have that experience, and this person does not. So, for instance, you could be, your job could be finally doing great, Scorpio, or you could just be starting a new job, and this person, and you has been talking about it for so long about, oh, getting a job and getting money coming in and finally something is breaking off for you, but nothing is breaking off for them. Like they're still kind of like, and they're acting within this energy like, yeah, I got this job offer too. When they find out that you're being so successful or you're on the way to success, the same thing with love. They make it seem like they wanted the same things with you. But then they truly didn't. Okay, let me just tap into. Oh my God, what this person feels for you, right? And then let's take it from there. All right, so what does this person feel for Scorpio? Holy Spirit, Holy Angels, Holy Father. What does this person's energy for Scorpio? What's 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 this person's energy for Scorpio? Wow, a lot. They have a lot going on, and you're gonna have to take up a lot to be with this person. All right, so I'm seeing the Page of Pentacles, no secret there. Oh my God, the artist. I'm seeing like the Queen of Swords. So there, the good thing about this is that there's going to be some conversation. Okay, this person is going to make their way towards you because they're getting some kind of download or some form of understanding from their crown chakra. Okay, the angels are just down, like showing them like this is what you don't do. Okay. What you don't do to people, period. So they're being taught, and so they're being taught, and now they want to talk to you. Now they have this new form of like understanding. Oh my God, I can't believe I was like this person to you. I'm sorry, kind of vibe, right? Then we have the artist here, and I feel like you need to pay attention, okay? Because this person is like, there are some things that have happened within this connection that you both missed because this is their energy, this is how they think about you. Like this is something like there's something within this artist, there's some kind of detail that you both missed. I feel like this person, maybe this person was trying to be open with you, but they found out that they really couldn't. I don't know. I feel like when they look at you, they see competition, they see jealousy. Remember we talked about that. I see deceit. I see like this person is trying to be better than you. I feel like this person is trying to make you like them, but the funny thing about it, they don't know you, Scorps. They don't know you, and I feel you because I'm a Scorpio too. But they're misjudging you. Like they don't understand. Scorpio is so different from other zodiac signs. Like we don't care about money. We like money. Money is good, so we can get food and we can get our things that we want. But we don't care about what our person has. We will be with them if we love them. If we love them, we're fucked. Yo, don't come for me. I don't mean to curse, but it's the truth, right? Scorpios, y'all love deep. Y'all the deepest sign in the zodiac. When y'all love, I mean, Cancers love deep too, but y'all love, y'all very loyal. That's the thing. Like, it's hard for you to leave someone that you love. You just can't separate from like that, from like how other zodiacs can just leave somebody behind and move on like 3 months later. You still in that feeling for somebody. You still in love with them, and you know, y'all not together. They could be moved on with somebody else, but you still, you know, longing for them. But this person is like, there's some things that you don't know about them. You missed a lot. They're saying that you don't even know them, and they don't know if they can open up to you. I feel like this person was trying to play a part. They were trying to play a part. They were trying to act like they were okay, but look, they're not. They're not okay. And they're saying that you missed that. They got a lot of drama. And I know we got a card like that. They got a lot they carrying on their back. And I feel like they've been doing it for a long time. But either way, you know, second chance. This is what this person wants. They've been juggling a lot and they're overwhelmed. They need your help. They don't got no money, okay? But it's okay, because Scorpios, we don't care about that. We don't care about that. At least some, okay? If you're a Gemini moon, then if you're a Scorpio sun, Gemini moon, oh, well, that's, yeah, you do care about money. You're going to be like, hell nah. Hell nah. You know what I'm saying? You ain't going to be doing that. This person need to get a job, J-O-B, somewhere. Okay? All right, so... Let's see what your energy is for this person. Scorps. What's Scorps' energy for this person? Holy Spirit, Holy Father, Holy Angels. What's the energy for Scorpio? What Scorpio's gonna do? When it comes to this person, what Scorpio's gonna do? You're looking at this person as toxic. All right, so the Nine of Swords, you're releasing any kind of stress, depression, or anything that this person has placed in you, any kind of fear. You're forgiving this person. That's what I'm seeing. You're like, okay, forgive this person, but you're looking at this person as someone that doesn't know what they want. You're looking at this person as toxic, Gemini, Virgo energy, and the Magician in reverse. So you're looking at this person that they have hurt you and said a lot of things, but you're forgiving this person. That's what you're saying. Like, I forgive this person for saying what they did, for giving me an STD for some of y'all, for putting me in the hospital for some of y'all, for stress, depression, anxiety, whatever, and don't care. I'm forgiving this person, okay? I'm forgiving this person for stepping all over me. I'm forgiving this person for being married. I'm forgiving this person. Look, the devil is here. This person was stuck for so long, lying to you, manipulating your mind, making you think that they were going to do something or change something about themselves. But that explains the Page of Pentacles all this time. This person have done nothing. They were waiting for something, but they wouldn't really do nothing. And then they're kind of stuck. They're giving me stuck vibes with the Devil and the Chariot. Confused. But you are just like, you're not making any moves towards this person, because this is what this person looks like. I'm just going to be a little bit nosy, y'all. Yeah, you're blocking this person, and it's a large form of energy that you're using. Two of Cups in reverse. You love them. You will always love them, okay? But you are doing what's best for you, okay? You're nurturing, you're kind, you're beautiful, you're attractive, but you're ending whatever this is. For some of you, you used to be married to this person. That's gonna be a marriage or some kind of foundation where you had a house, cars, money together, tied up together. Because I'm seeing a whole family tree here. I'm seeing like a eruption, you know, like your decision affected a lot of different people. Like this had a side effect, this decision. A lot of you could have businesses together or work together. But either way, you know, you appreciate the lessons that this person put you through. You don't regret being with them. You love that, you know, you guys learned a lot from each other. All right? But there's no trust. money is missing and independence is missing and power is missing and oh my gosh, let this person affect you. And you're leaving this. Look at this completion. It's done. It's over with. Whatever this is. If this person wants you back, because I'm seeing like they're trying to ask you back. They probably, oh my God, I can't. Why am I stuttering when I come to y'all? I'm telling you, like this person has a lot to say. They have a lot of messages and they have me stuttering in here. Okay? All right. So I feel like if this person wants to be with you, they're going to have to change. It has to be a change. Okay? What's the future energy? The future energy for this person in Scorpio, please. What is this future energy? Holy Spirit, Holy Father, Holy Angels. What's this energy for the future for Scorpio and this person? I'm just going to split it real quick. Thank you, Holy Spirit, Holy Father, Holy Angels. Okay, future energy, 6. Wow, I'm seeing you guys together. I'm seeing you forgiving this person in the future. Like, when I say together, I'm seeing you as friends. Yeah, I'm seeing you as friends. You're finding out the truth. You've got your self-esteem back, your confidence back. You know, I'm seeing you guys chilling. I'm seeing you guys making money, if that was a thing. I'm seeing you guys, you know, bettering yourselves. I'm seeing you in each other's lives, okay? The 7 of Swords, no, not 7, the 5 of Swords is in reverse, so they're waiting the white flag. All right, I don't see that Ace of Swords because I wouldn't trust it. I wouldn't tell you I trust it. But right now, for now, they're waving that white flag for you. They're like, they don't want to have any kind of deceit anymore. They don't want to argue with you. They don't want to betray you. They don't want to deceit you. They don't want to make you feel down. They don't want to talk all over you. They don't want to be jealous of you anymore. I feel like, but this person doesn't have many money. And they're not trying to build up their lives. Look at that. The 8 of Pentacles. This is who they are, even in the future. You're the King of Pentacles, you guys. You guys need to be careful who you bring into your life. You can't just bring anybody into your life because you're going to be picking up their, you know, it's okay if you love somebody, but just make sure if they don't have money, that's fine. Because I don't care about money. I don't care. I feel like two people can make it work, you know? But for some reason, Scorpio, people think that, I don't know what is it about our energy, but people think that they need to lie to you to be with you. You understand? They need to lie to you for some reason. They see you. They see how you carry yourself. They see what you're all about. They see that you're smart. They see that you're determined. They see that when you talk about self, you go for it. And that scares the crap out of them. They see that, you know, you can be silly. You could be free. You could be wild, right? When you're having fun. But when it comes to business and it comes to your job and it comes to your money, you're a totally different person. You're so like professional, and they look at you and they're like, hold on now, how did you just like come, you know, you're so ghetto one moment and then you're so like fresh the next when you're on the phone with your customer or something, and when you're doing business, it's like you know how to talk to people. You know, you're not a social person, but if you're put in that position, fire energy come out of you where you're just like that person, you know, vibration come out. I don't know how to explain it, where you're just like, you find yourself looking like a Gemini or Aquarius or a Libra energy for some people, and you get mistaken for that. Like, they swear that you are Gemini, Aquarius, and Libra because you're so free spirited, and when you go out with your friends, they just love having you there because you're the light of the party. Everybody tells me that I'm the light of the party, but I feel like I'm so boring, but they feel like I'm fun when I'm out with them. They love having me out with them. I don't know. But I like having them out with me. But they're saying I'm the life of the party. Like, it's crazy. But I'm a Scorpio, so I'm very laid back. But that's it. You just know how to blend in certain situations, and this person does not. Something about them, I don't know, and this card keeps coming up, Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus energy. I don't know who you're dealing with, and this person might be in reverse as a Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus, okay, where they just not stable, they're not having no place to live, they're all over the place, they're just not balanced in life, And I'm seeing that you're going to have to make a decision. You're still trying to find out what to do here. You're trying to make peace. You don't want to break any bridges with this person. This is why you have them in your future. You're feeling sorry for them. Your life is moving on. You're having so much opportunity, blessings, abundance coming your way. And this person is not going anywhere. And this is where you need to be careful because you're so forgiven. What? You're forgiving this person for every kind of lies and deceit that they placed in your life. But you're forgiving them. This is what I have for y'all. Be careful. Be careful. Be careful. I don't like this person, y'all. They're not trying and they're trying to like stick themselves on you and manipulate your mind and make you feel sorry for them. For some of you, this person could be telling you sob stories. They did too much for you to have them in your life like that. I mean, you need to see them on the streets and say hi to them, but you don't need to have coffee and lunch with them, okay? And be sitting with them and making plans and money. No. Okay? This card too, it could be a school card, but I'm seeing like for any kind of new information when it's furthering your ability to make money, when it's like going back to school or taking a class or becoming better, to better yourself, anything to better yourself, you're including this person in the future. What is this? This is what I have, y'all. I love y'all. Be careful out there. And I'll see you guys in your next one. Bye, guys.